At 29, Chloé Zhao left New York to meet the people of Pine Ridge in South Dakota. She wanted to understand the question that people often ask. Why don't they just leave if life is so hard? What struck her was the complex and strong bond that people had to their land and community. As a Chinese filmmaker who has studied in the UK and the US, Zhao says that she has drifted too much to ever feel attached to a place. This subject inspires all of her work and is most explicitly explored in her first feature, Songs My Brothers Taught Me. In Songs My Brothers Taught Me, Johnny lives on the Pine Ridge Reservation with his sister Jay Sean and their single mother Lisa. Throughout the film, he wrestles with leaving his family in order to move to Los Angeles with his girlfriend Aurelia.
I haven't told him about me moving to LA yet.
You don't even worry about it, just go. Just get off this res.
Locked up in jail, Johnny's brother is encouraging of the move because he knows that life is hard on the reservation. Crime and alcoholism are high. And since the purchase and consumption of alcohol has been banned, Johnny himself has become a criminal, working as a bootlegger. Despite all of this, leaving becomes increasingly hard.
Come on. Monkey, what are you doing?
Are you really leaving me?
Wait! Wait up, Jay Sean!
I hate you!
As Johnny's dilemma intensifies, he returns to the Badlands increasingly. His shifting allegiance away from Aurelia and growing interest in staying put is shown through his magnetic relationship with local Angie and their trips to his favorite place. Johnny's interactions with the land are visceral in these moments. He's smeared with mud and he throws dirt in the air. Zhao suggests that Johnny is deeply connected to the land and where he's from. In Songs My Brothers Taught Me, Lisa is played by Irene Bedard. Bedard is a professional actress who, among many other roles, provided the voice of Pocahontas in Disney's animated film. Her co-stars, however, are non-professionals, with the cast almost entirely composed of people from the area playing fictionalized versions of themselves. Since Zhao writes her films around the people she meets, her scripts are often inspired by the events in their lives. When Jay Sean visits the remains of her house in the film, her reactions are genuine. Her house had just burnt down. That Jay Sean allowed Zhao and the crew to film her shows just how comfortable she must have felt on set. Zhao's process is about being open and present. Her films feel authentic because she captures what she sees. By featuring the real people of South Dakota, Zhao also brings to light a great American contradiction. Indigenous cowboys, who honor their Lakota ancestry by weaving feathers in their hats. Native American and cowboy culture aren't battling here. They coexist.
Come on, ready? Go!
Zhao's second feature is based on a group of these cowboys, members of the Lower Brule Sioux tribe. In The Rider, the central character is Brady, Brady Blackburn in Zhao's film, Brady Gendre in real life. Once a rising star of the rodeo circuit, Brady is warned that his riding days are over after a saddle bronc kicks him in the head, crushing his skull. Back home, he finds himself wondering what he has to live for when he can no longer do what gives him a sense of purpose, to ride and to compete.
You know, Lily, Apollo got hurt. And we had to put him down.
Nope. Nuh-uh.
It's not fair to the horse. He can't run and play and do what he wants to do. You know, I got hurt like Apollo did. But I'm a person, so I got to live.
Where are you going with that?
Where does it look like I'm going? I'm going to the rodeo.
Crazy?
Ladies and gentlemen, how about
Zhao's is a compassion-focused cinema, filled with characters who are trying their best. In interviews, Zhao has said that we live in a culture that celebrates winners. If a superhero loses their superpowers, they will usually win them back by the end of the film. But life isn't always like that. And Zhao is more interested in those who keep fighting on.
Say I won't, and I will.
Lane Scott has been Brady's best friend since the pair were toddlers. And although in real life, Lane was actually left paralyzed by a car accident, his injuries in the film were the result of a rodeo, exacerbating Brady's conflict. To rodeo, or stay at home.
Looking good, stud muffin.
Elsewhere, the film is peppered with people who have suffered as a result of living by the land.
How you doing, Frank?
Hey, Brady, how you doing?
Shit, I'm healing up.
That looks pretty wicked there.
Yeah, I'll be good to go before long.
The Rider isn't about disability. It features as part of life. Zhao, aware of how living with a disability has been portrayed in the past, doesn't want it to be the exclusive focus. This is evident with how Brady's sister Lily is portrayed. Lily lives with Asperger's syndrome, but it's never once mentioned. Zhao isn't interested in making issue films. She's interested in hopes and dreams. So although she may shine a light on the cultural and socioeconomic factors affecting her character's behavior, she tries not to comment on these. Zhao admits that before The Rider, she had watched a grand total of 3 Westerns. Still, her films call into question a lot of its myths. Rugged individualism is replaced with an emphasis on the importance of community, and Brady is depicted as vulnerable and sensitive, at odds with the masculine stereotype we so often see on screen. The men of Pine Ridge may have swallowed Western tropes, but these tropes are mostly portrayed as stifling.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
You know, I know about your hand. I know you ain't supposed to be rodeoing or anything like that. Must be tough.
Hollywood royalty Frances McDormand approached Zhao to direct Nomadland because she liked the way The Rider used male and Western genre tropes to tell a more universal story of triumph over adversity. Nomadland is based on Jessica Breuder's book, Nomadland, Surviving America in the 21st Century, and follows Fern, a 61-year-old woman who packs up her van and sets off on the road, following the collapse of a company town in rural Nevada. The film features an older cast, some of whom have been forced to live in vans for economic reasons, while others have rejected the white picket fence for a life of adventure. They are all rediscovering the American dream for themselves.
We not only accept the tyranny of the dollar, the tyranny of the marketplace, we embrace it. We gladly throw the yoke of the tyranny of the dollar on and live by it our whole lives.
Unlike her previous features, in Nomadland, Zhao chose a professional actress to play the lead. For Zhao, the choice was in part pragmatic. With The Rider, it was cowboys, it was a Western. Nomadland would be a harder sell. Aware of the prejudice against stories about older people and people on the periphery of society, Zhao felt McDormand would help get the film seen. In many ways, McDormand represents the Hollywood community at large. As Fern meets and listens to the nomads of the Midwest, they too get to know the characters they rarely cast for screen.
Hello, coffee?
Fans of Zhao's work will also recognize Kat Clifford, a folk singer who has appeared in all of her films. He has become part of what Zhao calls her cinematic universe, a world inhabited by non-professionals with balanced portrayals of the subjects explored. The road movie is another genre complicated. Zhao shows that the road isn't just romantic, it can be brutal too.
I'd probably recommend taking that money and putting it towards a different vehicle.
Yeah, no, well, I can't do that. I can't do that, see, because, all right, I live in there. It's my home.
Fern has been made houseless. Since the zip code where she's from has been cancelled, she has no option but to make it work on the road. Fern is healed on the road by the people she meets, but also nature. When she speaks about her former house, it's not the building she misses anyway. It's her garden. Fans' appreciation of the land mirrors Johnny's and Brady's in Zhao's other films. Perhaps one of the strongest elements that joins all of Zhao's films is her honouring of the environment, characterised by sweeping landscapes shot in golden hour, accompanied by orchestral scores. The films are imbued with a poetry and a meditative quality that ultimately speak of Zhao's love of nature and its humbling effect on all of us.